I had the privilege of visiting all the schools this past year and had a very good visit here at Our Lady's Academy and eating lunch with the girls, the young women, and it was a treat for me and very much a moment that I do remember. Now, when I visit the schools, what I usually try to do is do a little presentation, but also give the students a chance to ask questions. So one of the questions I got, and it wasn't here, and it wasn't there. So, one of the other schools, one of the little ones, be careful what you ask the little ones. One of the little ones said, do you dye your hair? I said, no, sweetheart, what you see is what you get. I earned all this. You know, the Lord really speaks to us in a profound way. And, you know, the reading from Jeremiah about the potter and the potter's clay, all of these years, and how many years have most of you been here? 12, 13, 4, 14, 15? You get older than me. Wow. All right, wonderful. And all of that time, the Lord's been working in your life, both from your families, but also through the faculty and staff here, and through your interaction, both as a class, but as a school. And that potter has been shaping and forming you. And it's been one kind of shaping and forming. And he speaks about it in the gospel today. Jesus said to his disciples, so he's speaking directly to you and to us. He says, as the Father loves me, so also I love you. He loves us. He loves us that much. Wow. Jesus loves us. And then he calls us to remain in his love. And so that's how he's been shaping and forming us with his love, with the love of God. And the love of God shaping and forming you into the young woman that you are now and graduate soon to be. And calling you in a special way to love in that same way. He's calling you to that special vocation of love. To be young women of holiness. Called to holiness. Yep. Each and every one of you. Yep. If you need holy water, I got it. I got you covered. Calls you to holiness. And he also calls you to witness to his love in your life. And he says to each of us, that really needs to be the center of everything we do. So before Mass, I asked each of you where you were going to go to school. And wonderful, all the different places you're going. But you go with the love of God in your hearts. You go with the love of God calling you to witness to that love wherever you go. He says, you'll demonstrate my love for you as you keep my commandments. And the two great commandments, which are on the tip of our tongue always, is to love God with our whole heart and soul and mind and strength. It doesn't matter which degree we're going for. It's really about God loving God. And to love our neighbor as ourselves. During this year, you have loved your classmates. You have loved, I hope, your families. I could check with your parents now, but I won't. And that love is meant to truly be lived. You are called to be witnesses of Christ's love, disciples of Christ's love, a sign of Christ's love. So that when folks meet you and you say you're from wherever you are, Bay St. Louis, Past Christian, Waveland, wherever, they know the love of God is here. and present among us. And that Jesus is alive in your hearts. And Jesus is alive in your lives. That special relationship that Jesus Christ has with us is a relationship of love. And so in those difficult moments, and you're going to have one or two, right, parents? You're going to have one or two. Go to Him. Go to Him. Also, go to the people that really witness God's love to you. And He's going to be with you, no matter what. And He's going to love you into being. And the potter has not finished his product yet. He's still forming and shaping you into His sign of love. Each and every one of you, and all of us as a church. Final words of the gospel, Jesus says, "This I command you, love one another. Love one another." We pray for you that you may truly be a sign of the love of Christ. And whether you dye your hair or not, to let that love of God flow through your lives. That when people meet you, they will know you are a witness in God's love, and you are a witness of what it means to be Jesus Christ to the world, what it means to love one another.